Yeah, so let's continue looking at questions in the Quran, which the Creator asks, that cause us to really think, right? And today's question comes from ayah number 82 of Surah Nisa. Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. Do they not consider the Quran with care? If it had been from other than Allah, they would have found within it many discrepancies. So this is a question about the disbelievers here, right? Do they not consider the Quran with care? So the Quran was sent by Allah, and he didn't just say to simply believe in it, right? He sent it with evidence, with clear signs, so that we may scrutinize it and see the proof that it is from Allah. Because as he says here, if it had been from other than Allah, there would have been many discrepancies in it. Right? So the Quran was revealed 14 centuries ago. And it makes a lot of scientific statements, falsifiable statements, that if we were to examine these statements, we could tell whether the statements are true or false. Right? So the Creator, he describes the creation of the universe, the formation of the planet from smoke, right? When the heavens was once as smoke, and he said it come together. He describes the embryological development of human beings in the womb of the mother. All these things are clearly described in the Quran that was revealed 14 centuries ago. And when we scrutinize these statements, we find that they are true, right? So the Quran is consistent with scientific facts, with established scientific facts. And the Quran is also internally consistent. You will not find discrepancies where the Quran contradicts with itself and whatnot. And this is what you find when the Creator of the universe, the one who is all-knowing, the one who has power over all things, the one who is the most wise, when he authors a book, you expect that it is infallible. It is internally consistent and consistent with reality, with scientific facts. Right? And he says that if it had been from other than him, this would not have been the case. So, on my journey to Islam, you know, I questioned the authenticity of the Bible. I started researching who wrote the Bible, who really wrote the Bible. Right? So, in my journey, I got to find out that the Bible is not infallible as people say. You know, those who say that the Bible is infallible, they are making an emotional statement. Right? This is not a statement that can be considered academic or factual or based on any evidence. Anyone who does any research into the origin of the Bible, right, or into the contents of the Bible, would find that there are indeed a lot of discrepancies in the Bible, right? It's not in agreement with scientific facts in terms of how the universe was created, the order of creation. And it's also internally inconsistent. There are contradictions in the Bible where one part doesn't agree with another. There are different versions of events, contradicting versions of events. There's clear evidence that ordinary men added things to the Bible that weren't in the early manuscripts. So, this is what happens when a book is from other than Allah. You find within it many discrepancies. And there are authors who have written entire books about discrepancies in the Bible, right? There are websites which catalog the discrepancies. And even when people are examining the manuscripts from which the Bible was compiled, right? They find many, many discrepancies. There are compilations of discrepancies in the Bible, right? In which the compilations themselves are larger than the Bible. And I'm not making this up. I'll let you go and research this for yourself, right? There's an entire field of study called textual criticism, where biblical scholars, they examine the differences between Bible manuscripts, and they sort of try to estimate and reverse engineer what the original scriptures would have said. This is because they simply don't have the originals, and what they have are scriptures that were edited and tampered with by ordinary men. Right? So this entire field of study called textual criticism is dedicated to trying to piece together different versions of manuscripts and reject some parts because they were obviously, you know, fabricated, and then they accept some parts because they appear to be consistent throughout many manuscripts. There's a methodology with which they compare variant manuscripts to try to ascertain or to reverse engineer what the originals would have said, because they don't have the originals, right? And they have many discrepancies, and the list of discrepancies, right, is bigger than the Bible itself. Imagine that. It is impossible to deny that there are indeed discrepancies in the Bible. There's clear evidence that ordinary men, you know, they tampered with the Bible, they fabricated verses and inserted them into the Bible. 1 John 5:7 is an example, as well as those verses in the book of Mark which say that you can drink poison. It's clear that these are discrepancies, right? There's issues in the book of Genesis, where one part of the book of Genesis says that beasts were created before man, while another part says that men were created before the beasts. And there's hundreds of discrepancies, right? But we won't dwell on that too much. One discrepancy is too much, because if something is from the Creator, as Allah says, there should be no discrepancies. But when things are from other than Allah, you find many discrepancies. And we looked at the fact that the Quran is indeed free from discrepancies, right? It is internally consistent. It is consistent with established scientific facts, and it is free from errors, right? The Quran has been preserved verbatim. There's only one Quran, and this Quran is the same verbatim Quran that was revealed 14 centuries ago, right? Nobody had a chance to edit it, tamper with it, corrupt it in any way. And the Creator preserved the Quran for us to scrutinize. It is a living miracle, right? And when you look at it, you can see clearly that it is from Allah. It contains clear proof, clear evidence. So on this issue alone, one should truly consider the Quran. Think of it as a challenge and consider the Quran with care. Go and examine and scrutinize the Quran, and you will see clear evidence. Based on the information presented therein and the accuracy of it, you will see clear evidence that no other than Allah himself could have authored this Quran, and that it is indeed a revelation from him, and it could not have been generated by men, because we see what happens when men generate literature, right? It contains discrepancies. And this is human nature. We're only human. We make mistakes. But Allah doesn't make mistakes. So go and see for yourself. And I invite you to read the Quran and see this proof. Assalamu alaikum.